अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द फेशियल नर्व, दैट इज सेवंथ क्रैनियल नर्व. इट इज अ मिक्स्ड नर्व. इट्स न्यूक्लियस लाइज इन द पॉन्स. इट इमर्जेस फ्रॉम द स्कल थ्रू स्टाइलोमेस्टेट फोरामेन एंड गिव्स ऑफ ब्रांचेस. फाइव मोटर ब्रांचेस सप्लाई मसल्स ऑफ द फेस. ओके, there are five motor branches which supply the muscles of the face. Nerve 2 stapedius supply stapedius in middle ear. Sensory branches carry cutaneous sensations from the small part of the external ear. Sensory part also carries taste sensations from the interior 2/3 of the tongue. And there are also secretomotor fibers which supply lacrimal, submandibular or sublingual glands. These are the branches of the facial nerve. For examination of the motor function, what we do? We do inspection and then we check the actions of the facial muscles. We will do it after some time. For sensory examination or function, to test the sensory function, we check taste sensations on the anterior 2/3 of the tongue, and you have already done that practical. And second, we do Schirmer test. We will do it today. The apparatus that is used in this practical is the Schirmer test is the blotting paper. Protocol of the practical we will follow, that we will introduce ourselves to the subject, we will take consent, we will explain the procedure. For the motor function, in the inspection, what we will do? We will observe the face for the symmetry of eye blinking and eye closure. We will do it after some time, and then second we will check spontaneous movements of the face, upper and lower muscles during actions like smiling. Then we will check the functions of the facial muscles. We will ask the subject to frown or wrinkle the forehead. And what we will check by this? We will check the functions of the occipitofrontalis muscle. Then we will ask the subject to close the eyes as strongly as possible, and we will try to open it. In this way, we will check the integrity of the orbicularis oculi muscle. Then we will ask the subject to show his teeth, and we will check the levator labii muscle. Then we will ask the subject to whistle. This will check the orbicularis oris muscle. Then we will ask the subject to inflate the cheeks with closed mouth, and we will tap on both sides with fingers, and this will check the buccinator muscle. Now we will perform. Okay students, now facial nerve is most commonly affected cranial nerve in the lesions of upper and lower motor neurons. Upper motor neuron lesions can be unilateral or bilateral. Unilateral lesion can be due to vascular diseases, due to cerebral tumor or multiple sclerosis. And bilateral lesion can be due to vascular diseases or motor neuron diseases. In the upper motor neuron lesion, involvement of facial nerve, we see the lesion or we see the features or on the opposite side of the face. And in this case, upper half of the face is less commonly affected because upper half of the face is bilateral representation of the facial nerve on that part of the face. Lower motor neurons lesion can also involve facial nerve. It can also be unilateral or bilateral. Whenever there is unilateral lesion, Bell's palsy can develop. Unilateral lesion, again, very important. This Bell's palsy is very important. It is very frequently asked in the practicals, in the vivas. What is Bell's palsy? What type of lesion develops in the, what type of lesion is in the Bell's palsy, what are the features of Bell's palsy, what is the nerve involvement in the Bell's palsy. So students, be careful and read very thoroughly and carefully Bell's palsy. Then head injury can also cause unilateral lesion, and tumor of the base of the skull can also cause unilateral involvement of the lower motor neuron lesion. Bilateral lesion can be due to neurosarcoidosis and due to myasthenia gravis. And in the lower motor neuron lesion, there is whole of the ipsilateral half of the face is affected. So, what is the difference? In the lower motor neuron, whole of the ipsilateral half of the face is affected. Yani, what does it mean? Ki jis taraf ka lesion hoga, us taraf ke hi face pe ki involvement hogi, us taraf ke hi side ki. Or in case of upper motor neuron lesion, opposite side of the face is involved and upper half of the face is less affected because of the bilateral representation of that part of the face. Okay. Now, signs of facial nerve paralysis. If facial nerve is paralyzed, what signs will develop, can develop in the patient? There will be inability to close the eyes, as we have seen in when we were doing the checking the motor functions of the facial nerve, we check the eye muscles, and when there is lesion of the facial nerve, patient will not be able to close the eyes. There will be collection of the food in the mouth, dribbling of saliva on the affected side, deviation of the angle of the mouth towards healthy side due to unopposed action of the healthy muscles. Patient can hear abnormally loud sound on paralyzed side if the nerve to the stapedius muscle is involved. Palpable fissure may be by nasolabial fold will be flat on the affected side or paralyzed side. Eyes remain open, or they can be upward rolling of the eyeball, that is known as Bell's phenomena. There will be no wrinkling of the forehead. Patient will be unable to inflate his cheeks or her cheeks and will not be able to whistle, or air will escape from the paralyzed side. So student, this was all about the facial nerve, its origin, and what are its sensory motor part, motor functions, and if it is paralyzed, what features you can see. So if you have any queries, you are most welcome to ask. To examine the motor part, what we do, first of all we do inspection, then palpation. In the inspection, we inspect the muscles of mastication, and then we palpate for the tone and strength of the muscles of mastication. We do jaw jerk. Now, the apparatus that is used in this practical is with cotton for fine touch, pins to test pain sensations, Weber campus, this is Weber campus, and clinical hammer. We will follow the protocol, that is, we introduce ourselves to the subject and we will explain the procedure. We will take his consent. The subject should be calm and comfortable, and we perform the test on both sides of the body. Now, I will tell you after some time that what is the procedure and how to check this nerve. For the sensory part, general sensations are tested on both sides of the midline in the three sensory division of the trigeminal nerve. Touch, pain, and temperature are tested on forehead, cheeks, nose, lips, and chin, and 2-point discrimination is tested on the upper and lower lips. So what sensations we check? We check fine touch, pain, temperature, 2-point discrimination, and then we will do corneal and conjunctival reflex. In the conjunctival reflex, afferent nerve is fifth cranial nerve, center is pons, and efferent nerve is seventh cranial nerve. And what we do, how we elicit, we ask the subject to look at the ceiling. Then we take a wisp of cotton and we touch the lateral margin of the sclera. What response should come? There should be bilateral blinking of the eyelids and the two sides should be compared. For the corneal reflex, afferent is fifth cranial nerve, center is pons, efferent is seventh cranial nerve. The stimulus that we're using, that we're applying is touch. And the same that we ask the subject to look at the ceiling. We take a wisp of cotton, but in corneal reflex, we touch the cornea at the corneoscleral junction. In conjunctival reflex, we touch the lateral margin of the sclera. We touch the lateral margin of sclera, but in corneal reflex, we touch the cornea at the corneoscleral junction. And there is also bilateral blinking of the eyelids and the two sides should be compared. Why bilateral blinking occur? It is due to contraction of the orbicularis oculi muscle. Assalamu alaikum Amir bhai, mera naam Dr. Masoom hai aur hum aapke chehre ke patthon ka muayna karne lage hain. Isme hum aapko kuch hidayat denge jis pe aapne amal karna hai, aap iski ijazat dete hain
ji.
Thank you. In the inspection, what we will do, we will observe the face for the symmetry of eye blinking and eye closure, and we will ask the subject to do the smiling, or we will also look for the spontaneous movement of the face, and particularly during actions like smiling. Amir bhai, aap apni aankhon ko band kare. We will look for both eyes. Khole, band kare, khole. So we have checked it. Now ab aap thoda sa muskuraye. Theek hai, thank you. So we have done our inspection. Now we come to the actions of the facial muscle. अब आपने माथे पे बल डालना है, ठीक है? देखें, look at it, ऊपर की तरफ देखें, ये. So the wrinkles are present over the forehead. In this way, what we have checked? We have checked the integrity of the occipital frontalis muscle. अब आप आ जाएं सर. अब हम क्या करेंगे? We will ask the subject to close the eyes as strongly as possible while the examiner tries to open them. आप अपनी आँखों को जोर से बंद करके रखेंगे और ये कोशिश करेंगे खोलने की, लेकिन आपने खोलने नहीं देने. जी, ठीक है. अब दूसरी आँख चेक करें. In this way, we have checked the integrity of the orbicularis oculi muscle. Now we will ask the subject to show the teeth. आप अपने दांत दिखाएं. So, ठीक है, thank you. In this way, we have checked the levator lobi muscle. अब आप CT पे जाके दिखाएं. Okay. Now we have checked the orbicularis oris muscle. Now, what we will do? We will ask the subject to inflate the cheeks with closed mouth and we will tap on both sides with finger. In this way, we will check the buccinator muscle. अब आपने इस तरह करना है कि अपने मुंह में हवा भरनी है और मुंह को बंद रखना है और हम जो है उसको चेक टैप थोड़ा सा टच करेंगे. अब आप आ जाएं. सो ओके, थैंक यू. यू हैव सीन दैट बाय टचिंग व्हेन द माउथ वाज क्लोज्ड द एयर डिड नॉट कम आउट. So in this way, we have checked the integrity of the facial muscles and all the muscles are intact. Thank you. Now we are going to check the secretomotor function of the facial nerve, and for this we do a Schirmer test. What we do in this test, that we place a blotting paper at the outer margin of the lower eyelid and remove after 5 minutes. What happens? Normally at least 10 millimeter blotting paper is damped by the evoked tear secretion. अमित भाई, अब इस तरह है कि हम आपके आँख के निचले हिस्से में ये पेपर रखेंगे थोड़ी देर के लिए, ठीक है जी. इस तरह लोअर आईलिड के साथ हम 5 मिनट्स के लिए जब इनकी आँख में रखेंगे तो ये इनकी आँखों में आंसू आएंगे और उससे ब्लोटिंग पेपर जो है वो गीला हो जाएगा.